हेलो एवरीवन, आई पुनीत उपाध्याय, एचओडी ऑफ मैकेनिकल डिपार्टमेंट, हैंडलिंग द सब्जेक्ट मैकेट्रॉनिक्स। सो बिफोर बिगनिंग द नेक्स्ट सेशन, लेट अस डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग द सेशन 8। सो इन सेशन 8, व्हाट ऑल यू हैव स्टडीड, वी हैव स्टडीड व्हाट इज एन एसी मोटर। सो व्हाट इज बेसिकली एन एसी मोटर? एन एसी मोटर इज एन इलेक्ट्रिकल मोटर विच इज ड्रिवन बाय द अल्टरनेटिंग करंट। सो दिस इज रिगार्डिंग द एसी मोटर। नेक्स्ट, द डीसी मोटर। द डीसी स्टैंड्स फॉर द direct current. So what happens in here in DC motor? It is a motor which in any class of the rotary electrical motors that converts the direct current electrical energy into the mechanical energy. Next, the working of the AC motors. So basically here in the working of AC motor, we have seen the two halves, that is first half period and the second half period, where the current reverses from north pole to the south pole in first half, and in second half from south pole to the north pole, that is the in the second half. This is working of the AC motor. Next one is the DC motor. So what happens in the DC motor? You can see here there are two poles, that is north pole and the south poles. Okay, when they come when these both poles current combined, they form the driving torque, just remaining the constant of the direction of the force. So this is nothing but the DC motors. Then some part are regarding the important questions for the examinations. So this is regarding the session. Next session is the session 9, which is a continuation of the session 8. So in this session, what you are going to cover? So here you can study regarding the stepper motor, the types of the stepper motor, the terms used in the stepper motor, then the what is the ratchet and pawl, and the important questions for the examination. Let us begin with the stepper motor. So what is the stepper motor? A stepper motor is also known as a step motor or stepping motor, okay, which uses the brushless DC electric motor that divides a full rotation into a number of equal steps. There are basically three types of the stepper motor. First one is the permanent magnet stepper, second one is the variable reluctance stepper, third one is the hybrid synchronous stepper. So what happens in stepper motor? Okay, here it uses the brushless okay DC electrical motor that divides the full rotation into the form of the step by step. So this is nothing but the stepper motor. Next comes the terms used for specifying stepper motor. First one is the angle accuracy, angle transmission error, atomic current cutback, backlash, clockwise, counterclockwise, gravitational operation, inertial load, misstep, resonance, then the thrust load. Next come the ratchet and pawl. So what is ratchet and pawl? The purpose of this ratchet and pawl is to allow a shaft to rotate in one direction only. Okay, so what is ratchet and pawl? It allows the shaft to rotate in one directions. Next one, this is explained with the help of the simple figure. So here basically the ratchet is a wheel in a shape similar to the circular saw blade or horizontal milling cutter. So this represents the ratchet wheel, okay, which is in the shape of the milling cutter, okay, horizontal milling cutter. The ratchet fits into the shaft. So here you can see the hole which is fitted into the shaft for the rotations, and it is locked onto the shaft by a key. Okay, so to provide the vibrations, it is locked by the key. Here you can see the red color, it is nothing but the key. The key fits into slots and shaft and the ratchet wheel. These slots are called as the keyways. So here this is a key, okay, which fits in the slots between the shaft and the ratchet, which does not permit the wheel to come outside. Now next, the pawl. Here you can see the blue color, this is the pawl. The pawl is a metal part that rests on the ratchet. Okay, as the ratchet rotates, the pawl drops onto the each of the steps onto the ratchet rim, preventing the ratchet from turning in the direction of the pawl. So what happens? Okay, when the wheel starts rotating, this pawl is operated. Okay, this moves up and down. Okay, so when these wheels start rotating, what happens? This pawl does, ball it come from one position to the another position, that is from one teeth to the another teeth, and does not allow the ratchet to move backward. So the ratchet should move in only one directions. So this is the nothing but the anti-clockwise directions. So this is the clockwise directions. So this ratchet prevents the wheel, okay, to rotate in a one directions. It does not allow the wheel to come back to the backward directions. So this is basically the function of the pole. So it is nothing but the ratchet and the pole. Next, the important questions for the examinations. So there are five important questions that are asked in the examination point of view.